Let's demonstrate a Cardsmith use case for team brainstorming and action planning. After all, what good's a brainstorm if it doesn't cause some action? We're getting the remote team together and we're going to brainstorm some ideas for increasing signups to our web application. That's our problem statement. So I've created a board already. I've got a card at the top and we're going to get everybody on Skype and we've got the board shared and we're all going to brainstorm on the board live. And everybody can start putting their cards on the board right away, and everybody's ideas show up immediately on everybody else's view of the board. And you could even open some of these cards up and find out that people have added their own notes too. So once we have all our ideas out, we want to start organizing and prioritizing them. And for that, we're going to go to our grid view. And you can organize however you want, but in our brainstorming, we decided on three categories for our marketing projects: easy marketing, ones that might take more effort, and ones that require development. So we can move those into each column. Once we've categorized the projects, we're going to rank them, and we want to end up with the project that's the highest priority at the top, based on what our team's idea of the project's value is. So now that we've done the brainstorming, we're going to make an action plan. So I'm going to put a row up above here so we can focus on the most important project. So I can just drag these up here. And if I delete this row, then all the other cards go back into the unfiled cards area. And I'm also going to color these, because on our team we color cards based on what team member is going to have responsibility for that project. So now that we've identified what's important, we're going to add tasks to each project. So I'm going to insert a row below where we can add task cards. And the team is going to create these cards that will let us estimate hours for each task. We can color the cards to assign ownership. And if we want to see how long we think everything's going to take, we can also go up here and look at grid totals. So I'm going to say, give me the estimated hours for a column, since that's a project. And this one shows 10 estimated hours, and we're getting that value from the number that's on each of those cards, which is going to change dynamically as we finish tasks and move them out of the column. And then when we're ready to take on another project, we can always go back to our original freeform design and see what other things we're ready to start on.